Hello, everybody. On my way to Monte Carlo. Just left the house. The Leaf game was in overtime, and I'm thinking to myself, oh boy, am I going to miss this flight? Because, you know, you can't, like, leave in the middle of overtime, and it's hard to book a, or it's hard to change a flight all the way to Monte Carlo, but I considered it for a moment. Ultimately, you know, this is a serious trip. I'm going a couple days early. Want to be mentally prepared. Been really inspired to play poker. I go through phases sometimes where I'm really into it, or sometimes I'm like, whatever. Lately, I have been. I played a couple tournaments at Bellagio. We created a 10-game mix. I came in second in both of those. And then on Thursday, I went to play the 25K at the Aria as well, and made the final table, which isn't saying much because there's like 20 players. But, you know, I just lost the flip, which that whole tournament is a lot about flips. If you don't win flips, you're not going to win. There's some skill, obviously, to get there, but by the end of it, it's pretty much crapshooting. So I'm also fasting today. I don't know if you guys know what the jet lag food trick is, but if not, Google it. It works. 12 to 16 hours before the time you want to wake up in the new time zone, you stop eating. So I stopped eating around, you know, 1 o'clock today, and I'm going to eat again on the plane. Flight leaves at 9:30 p.m. I'm going to eat again at 1 a.m. or so, and that'll be like 10 a.m. in the new time zone where I'm going over to Monte Carlo. So yeah, I'm excited. We got the 100K, which is different than these like crapshooty high rollers. There's a lot of play. I feel really good about where my head's at with poker. I'm ready to get streaky. You know, I'm a pretty streaky player. Always have been. So along the way, hopefully, you know, through this vlog, we'll get you to the end with some trophies and a big stack of cash. Funny looking cash though, euros and stuff. They're all different colors, like Monopoly money.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if I'm focused. I just had a drink, it was potent. Then I went and wrote this like, oh shit. I be wavy like the oceans, I'm coasting. Yeah. What you mad, you look hopeless. Pouring up a drink, more like pouring up emotions. I'm putting down the open, I'm about to go in, yeah. I'm about to go in, yeah. I woke up and looked myself in the face. Said everything and everything's gonna be okay. You ain't gotta stress it, just go on with your ways. I ain't worried about what anybody has to say. Man, I've been chilling, writing raps today. But this shit's just on my phone, it's kinda driving me insane. Worth ethic, it needed change. These raps were getting plain, oh no. I just had to switch my flow, here it goes. Tuck it and roll it, I light it and then I smoke it. Enhances, it gets me going. I'm loving the way I'm flowing. But all these raps just get thrown away. I don't know why the feeling tends to go away. Used to feel it like I'm realist, that's on Mary Jane. See the vision, yeah, I built it. And I ain't done with this project. I just started building the greatest building of buildings. The castle is how I'm feeling. I'm trying to bring the bills in, but money, it has no feelings. That's I don't know if I'm focused. I just had a drink, it was potent. Then I went and wrote this like, oh shit. I be wavy like the oceans, I'm coasting. Yeah. What you mad, you look hopeless. Pouring up a drink, more like pouring up emotions. I'm putting down the open, I'm about to go in, yeah. I'm about to go in, yeah. What you mad, cause I wrote this. Rhyme the same word, I don't care, they won't notice. As long as it sounds good and it keeps flowing. At least it's what they told us. But I was like, hold up, wait, oh it's alright. We live a different life. All I know is to piss and write. Y'all like the bars that I like to type. I'm pissed off, why can't y'all get this right? Quote unquote, say you live this life. But the artists say right, I'm in the office like white. I appeal at sight, look around, the shit's twisted. Rappers been getting famous off of one hit, they trending. What is this? No time for bitching, it's time
you don't
to
see
go
this
get
often
in
my story is what I'm pitching. The origin of these writings, rapping, I'm not like a chair for
the think you talking big, you ain't even authentic. Flexing with all those cars, but most of those cars rented. You probably pull a drink and have all your bars written. Not trying to take shots, but my shots still hitting. Writing the same plot, you're adding a different ending. Swear I had y'all hooked by the first fucking sentence. Get it, you don't get it, what a sad life you living. I'ma be happy, do this whole thing different. Started with small winnings and flipped it to big endings. That's how I'm living.
I don't know if I'm focused. I just had a...
So it's Monday around 10 p.m. We left Las Vegas 9:30 Sunday, so, and then you get the 9 hours or whatever. I like landing at night because, you know, you're already kind of tired. I'm on track with the whole jet lag food trick thing, feeling really good. I have a couple extra days. Normally I come in like a day before and have one day off. I got two. So that should really help me for the super high roller, and I'm super excited about that. Got the trusty blender. Hey. why do I get so excited? Because there's a blender here. I don't know. So anyway, the plan for tonight is just chill, unpack, put all my stuff away like I plan to be here for the whole time, because that's the plan. And then in the morning, head to the gym and just get back on track and eat at the right times and all that kind of stuff. And hopefully just snap out of the jet lag immediately. So it's 8 a.m., beautiful day. It's like really nice out. The jet lag thing pretty much worked right away. I mean, I was up at 6 a.m., which is a little on the early side, of course, since I'm playing noon tournaments, but it's supposed to work after today. So today, I'm gonna eat at 10:30. We're gonna head over to EQ Vida, which is Novak Djokovic. You've heard of him, the tennis player. That's his restaurant. It's all plant-based, vegan. It's a little bit of a walk from here. After breakfast, we're gonna hit the gym and then probably hit the grocery store. All exciting stuff, right? Check me out. Woo!
Drink, it was potent. Then I went and rolled the psycho shit. I be wavy like the oceans I'm coasting. Yeah, yeah. What you mad? You look hopeless. Pouring up a drink, more like pouring up emotions. I'm putting down the open. I'm about to go in, yeah. I'm about to go in, yeah.
Okay, way too much at breakfast, so we're not ready for the gym yet. So we're gonna take the hike up the hill to the local market here called the casino, different kind of casino, and get some necessities, you know, just like I always do. It's been a nice day so far, but man, I'm full. That food is good at EQ Vida. Check it out, 15-minute walk from Monte Carlo Bay.
Me going, I'm loving the way I'm flowing, but all these reps just get thrown away. I don't know why the feeling tends to go away. Used to feel it like a realist, that's on Mary Jane. See the vision, yeah, I built it, and I ain't done with this project. I just started building the greatest building, the buildings, the castle is how I'm feeling. I'm trying to bring the bills in, but money, it has no feelings. That's I don't know.
All good on groceries, feeling good. It's what, 10 a.m. Gonna head to the gym. It's a little earlier than I would be back at home, but works for here. Somebody playing noon tournaments and plan to go to the gym beforehand. So I think it's good too. I mean, I've read some stuff about, you know, you go to the gym in the morning, wherever you get to, and I don't know. That part, I just lied. I'm just making that up. The jet lag food trick thing, that's true.
What you mad? Cause I wrote this, rhyme the same word. I don't care, they won't notice. As long as it sounds good and it keeps flowing. At least that's what they told us. But I was like, hold up, wait, oh, it's alright. We live a different life. All I know is to piss and write. Y'all like the bars that I like to type. I'm pissed off, why can't y'all get this right? Quote unquote, say you live this life. But the artists say, right, I'm in the office like white. I appeal at sight. Look around, the shit's twisted. Rappers been getting famous off of one hit, they trending.
It's game day, everybody. I'm excited. Yesterday, I spent the entire day, which was like 8 hours, laying in bed playing 400, 800, 8-game mix on PokerStars. It was a lot of fun. I really enjoy playing the mixed games. Good way to unwind. I don't get a lot of chance to play on PokerStars living in the United States in Las Vegas, so every time I get a chance, I try to take it. I ended up losing like 15,000 or 19,000 in the session. Whatever, it's not that much in an 8-hour session happens, but overall, I crushed that game. Like, I've actually done quite well ever since it's been there, and I tell you what, when I sit down, the game fills up with a list. As soon as I quit, game breaks. I wonder who they think the sucker is. Clearly me. Which is good, I guess, because it means I can get action. And I definitely see mistakes from my opponents in specific games. I'm sure I make some as well. But I will say that if I wasn't so secure in my poker game and my results and my ability to crush this game, like, you know, the wrong kind of person, if you behave that way, like as soon as they quit, you just all don't even play like for another 5-10 minutes, you send a really bad message. A, they might think that you guys are all friends and cheating, which is like the worst of the possibilities. Second is you're letting them know that you think he's not good, right? Which probably doesn't bode well for having you want him to come back. I'm different because I know I'm going to crush the game. Like, it's just the stud games especially, I think that they're just the players who play in that game don't necessarily play all those games well. I'm sure I give up something in a few of the games because that's natural, but otherwise, feel good about it. Woke up this morning, 9:30 a.m., feeling good, went to the gym, shoulder day, a little bit of abs, and I'm gonna go on time because I'm really excited to play. I'm inspired to play. I usually go like 4 levels late. I go to the gym in the first couple, but I really wanna play. I wanna get some reps in, if you will, and play some early levels. I've been really inspired to play. I've been doing a lot of study and really feel good about this one. I feel like so. My intention for this tournament, let's go there. My intention is to have a top 5 stack by the end of day 1, and that will exceed 500K in chips, which would end the day for me with 100 big blinds, which is plenty to play with, especially with my approach, very careful. So that's my intention for day 1. My intention for this tournament is, of course, to late Friday night have the trophy in front of me, I'm visualizing now. All the stuff I learned from all the mental coaches. Right? Visualizing the trophy, me shaking the guy's hand, saying, "Woo! Nice. Ace Jack holds against Ace Eight for all the chips." Watch, when it comes Ace Jack and Ace Eight for all the chips, you guys are gonna be like, "Oh my goodness, he predicted it." So that's the plan for today. Good news here, we got Kevin Hart playing in this tournament. If you guys don't know who Kevin Hart is, why are you living under a rock? Movie star. So he is playing in this one. And that's good for poker because he, you know, he does a lot. Like, you call this social media stuff valuable, but he does like Instagram. He's got, I don't know how many millions of followers, and he's really good about tweeting out the Poker Stars events and blah, blah, blah. So that's, you know, good for bringing new people into poker. And we need new people, because if you don't bring in new people from poker, all that's left are the sharks. And then the sharks start eating each other, and then, yeah, it doesn't work. So we need new players to come into the game and have fun. All right, guys, time for me to shower and head down there. What's up, son?
Oh, my name is Daniel. I got a poker patch.
What's up, buddy? How
are you, man?
See you, man.
How
are you? Say?
Are you going right now?
I'm going to go play, yeah.
What? So you guys are good, man. Is this like your strategy?
I don't usually, no. I usually go like 4 hours late, but I'm ready to play.
You ready?
Hungry. I'm ready. Inspired.
I'm going to go shower and come down right now.
Okay.
You think you got an edge on me? Is that what you think? You think you got a little edge on me?
A little bit. Just
don't wear this anymore.
Okay. You
I'm sorry.
Man, huh?
I'm sorry. That was just out of conduct. I'm just trying to get in your head. I'm sorry about that.
All right.
I'm sorry about that. I'll see you in a second.
Okay.
Dave, you smell great.
Aqua
what is
Gio.
That?
Aqua de Gio.
Aqua de Gio.
Gotta get some.
I thought it was loser. Yeah. Poker players think they better than me. They not. Sir, I'm the winner. Excuse me. What seat is mine? How you guys doing?
Good morning, sir.
Daniel, good morning to you. It's about time I got one of these. It's about time you guys realize what I'm capable of around here, Daniel.
Players.
Where's your fucking pants, man?
Sorry again.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
It's time to go get it. My story is what I'm pitching. The origin of these writings. Rapping, I'm not submissive. Passing up all you Kendricks. Think you talking big, you ain't even authentic. Flexing with all those cars, but most of those cars rented. You probably pull a drink and have all your bars written. Not trying to take shots, but my shots still hitting. Writing the same plot, you're adding a different ending.
Swear I had right. No hook by the first fucking. We got you out of bed to play 100K?
Get it, what a sad life you living. I'ma be happy do this whole thing different.
That's my starting table.
And nice. Flip it to big endings. That's how I'm living.
I don't know if I'm focused. I just had a drink, it was potent. Then I went and wrote this like oh shit. I be wavy like the oceans, I'm coasting. Yeah, yeah. What you mad, you look hopeless. Pouring up a drink, more like pouring up emotions. I'm putting down the open. I'm about to go in.
I'm gonna call it.
Call.
I'm gonna see what happens.
Solid first two levels, feel really good. I mean, I feel great right now. Just picked up the food from Loving Hut. They deliver here some vegan stuff. And I moved four times. I had a really good table, another really good table. Then I moved to the worst table. We moved to a table now that's not the best one. But playing really, really well, really focused. I feel great. It's a 20-minute break, so gotta run the dinner because I get lunch and dinner at the same time from Loving Hut. Eat the lunch now and then put the dinner in the fridge for later. And yeah, super excited. I've got 300,000, you start with 250, so that's all right. Can't complain.
Can I see your view, if I can read it?
Really good end to day one. I'm gonna tell you, I showed up on time, I felt good, like I said, played really good, and then like for an hour and a half, 2 hours, maybe three, just didn't hit nothing. Ended up busting with Jack 10 of Diamonds when I went all in, and got called by Kings, shocker, right? And then I was gonna like skip the last hour of the night and just maybe come back the next day. And Steve O'Dwyer says, you know, you should come back. I'm like, all right, why not? So I rebuy into the event and like the third hand in, I under the gun player raises to 11,500. I just call in under the gun plus two with aces because I'm looking to pick somebody up, right? Dan Smith on the button, re-raises to 36, comes back to me, I make it 88,000. He goes all in, I call, I double up right away to 500. And then I bust in with nines against ace queen and I win a few other pots. And like literally in that 40 minute period, I went from out to chip leader. I got 864,000 going into day two. Some funny stuff near the end. I wish I would've got this, but like this is tough because I'm actually playing. So it's hard to get a lot of shots to make this vlog super cool. So I'm doing the best I can. But at the end of the night, Kevin Hart and Dan Coleman apparently have a bet that tomorrow morning at 11 a.m., and maybe we'll go check it out, Dan has to run a 5K, 5 kilometers, in 22 minutes, right? So that's like 3 miles. He's going to have to run, what is that, like a 7-minute mile-ish or something like that? And apparently he doesn't run, but the kid's in good shape. You know, he's got the big guns. I see a guy, I snuck him in one time. Hey! and so I don't know. I think he might be able to do it. And he seems pretty confident. Kevin Hart is convinced he cannot do it. So it was fun to have Kevin Hart in the tournament. He made it through the day with 400,000. So he's in the game. He's ready to go. Having a lot of fun. Bringing a lot to the event, you know? Super cool. So the plan for tonight is I just did some interviews for GQ Magazine and whatnot. We'll check in with you guys tomorrow. No gym today. Today's day two. Second in chips, actually behind Daniel Lavores. Thought we were chip leader, but whatever. Close enough. I'm excited about it. Just decided to sleep in a little bit extra because I know today's going to be a long day. There's a dinner break. Won't get done till, I don't know, 12 or 1. My intention, quite clear, to make the final eight tonight in the top three in chips and then win it on Friday night.
I woke up and looked myself in the face. Said everything and everything's gonna be okay. You ain't gotta stress it, just go on with your ways. I ain't worried about what anybody has to say.
Yeah, this is what I'm up against. Booker 2017.
Okay, so end of the second level. We're sitting on about 1.2 million. Some tough cookies left. We got 19 players left. Pays the top eight. Up top is 1.7 million euro, which is more than American money. It's worth a lot. So I'm just gonna grab a quick bite, and then on the break, I have some interviews to do and stuff like that, trying to minimize the distractions, but hey man, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. And then I'm gonna try to get a nap in on the next dinner break, so keep you updated. Some tournaments you bust, and you're like, whatever, haha, everything's good, but this one was, you know, it's one of those painful ones. It's doing really good in chips. Up to 1.2, cruising along. Guy comes in, I'll tell you the two key hands. Guy raises, I have pocket aces, two black ones, pretty ones. I have 3-bet him on the button, he calls. Comes king 7-3, all spades. Good flop for my hand, he checks. I bet, he check raises all in. I'm like, all right, well, this could be, he could have a set of sevens, but I'm never folding, I'm getting the right price anyway. I call, set of sevens, and he makes a full house. No good, right? So now I'm down to whatever, like 450, still doing fine. And get moved to, well, I mean, not doing fine, I'm, you know, behind the average like 900. Get moved to the last two tables, raise under the gun with ace, queen of spades, just the big blind calls. The flop comes down, jack, jack, nine with two spades. So at this point, I'm pretty much going with it no matter what happens, most likely because of my stack size. He checks, I bet 50,000, he makes it 110. I'm like, oh man, I've only got like three more. So I re-raise him 100 more, just kind of silly. But he gets it all in with me and has the jack 10 of hearts. So I make the flush on the turn. Yes, I've got the nuts. Back in action over like average. And then the river is the 10 of spades. So he makes a full house. And that's me down 200,000 euro so far on the trip. One tournament in. Very frustrating because I thought I played really well throughout. And it was fun because there's a lot of tough competition. But I really like the way that I was approaching each decision, like, just unfortunate, you know? And that's the thing about tournament poker. When you play these things, you can make all the right moves and play well, and, you know, you're gonna need a little bit of cooperation from the deck. So I put myself in a good situation, you know? Didn't make the money, unfortunately. Was, you know, one table away. But, yeah, I can't complain about any of the, like, I'm looking back now if I'm gonna do that sort of, like, what worked, what didn't work. What worked was focus. I definitely was engaged. I was like really paying attention. I was thinking on a high level. I was aware of my competition and what I needed to do to compete with them. So all those things went really well. What didn't work? What didn't work? Oh, I didn't win. That's one thing. But other than that, what didn't work? I thought everything worked. I mean, so they're good. So that's what I look at it this way, right? I had an intention, which was to win the tournament. That didn't happen. But did I do everything that I could to win the tournament in terms of like my preparation, everything like that? Yes. So we're going to look at this as a win. Like we didn't win the tournament, but we won in terms of being in integrity, doing all the right things, you know, eating right, sleeping, focusing on the hands, playing fundamentally solid. So yeah, it's a good result. And I know the big scores are coming, you know, I just know. Anyways. that's the end of this. I couldn't get all the shots I wanted in this thing because obviously I was busy playing and whatnot, and they don't really let you do that. But hope you got a little glimpse into what it's like. And right now I'm a little, but you know, not like it's going to last. I'll be fine in 5 minutes.
Insane, worth ethic, it needed change. These raps were getting plain, oh no. I just had to switch my flow, here it goes. Tuck it and roll it, I light it, and then I smoke it and hit.